you know, what good I will think about it. Suppose this is just an example. Raj is an extremely established smoker. He is a chain smoker. This is just an example. I hope you are not. So suppose he is a chain smoker. And if I have to do some good to him, what I will think? Raj, give up smoking. Look at me, I don't smoke in public. See? So our goodness is imposition of our views on the society. Think, friends. And then it becomes such an obsession. That obsession is most dangerous and can create any havoc in the world. See? Yeah, day for yesterday in Shailaja's house, I was reading Time magazine. Some small, small quotes. One quote about some pastor in UK or US has beautifully said, if you are telling that the young people are taken for becoming terrorists, something like that, we are doing the same thing, bringing the people to Jesus. See, he's very right. Our goodness is imposition of our views on others. These three kinds of desires create disaster in our life. Therefore, this one object which creates desire in life, and second is now the people. The people, how they create desires in our life. Again, we'll take reference of Bhagavad Gita, first chapter. Arjuna's argument was, how can I kill my people, my guru and my grandfather? Meaning killing is not a problem. If it is your guru and your grandfather, I don't mind killing. But if it is my guru and my grandfather, then there is a problem. See, friends, therefore the desires are born out of two kinds of wrong interactions. One with the things and second with the beings. And whenever there is any desire in our mind, we cannot be at peace. That is called as ashanti. You must have experienced this. Suppose your flight is in the morning at 7 o'clock, international flight. So you have to report 3 hours before. If you have to go to USA, God bless you, you may not go there. They make you really miserable. Any airport you go. See? So 3 hours before you have to report to the airport. So 7 minus 3, so 4 o'clock you have to reach. And then from your house, the drive is 1 hour. So 3 o'clock you have to leave. So you decide, I'll sleep quickly, finish my sleep, become fresh, take a bath, have something to eat, and then leave the home at 2:30 so that I am there on time. And then you go to sleep at 8:30 or 9 o'clock. From 9 to 2:30, you wake up 250 times. I think it's honest. One desire, one thought destroys your peace, is it not? We have got the Himalayan quantity of thoughts. I want this, I want that. Go, 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 go. Inside, there is a poultry farm. There is not one. There are millions of them inside. And therefore, we all talk maximum to ourselves. Stop talking to yourself. You will be at peace. What is ashanti? Ashanti is talking to yourself. When we talk to ourselves and others don't listen, they are called as being sentimental. See? This is how when I go to so many places around the world, many people ask me, you are all alone traveling, don't you get bored? I said, no, I watch the cartoon show. But where are TVs? I said, oh, live cartoon shows. You just sit there on the bench and then watch. What is happening? That fellow is talking to himself. Such persons are called as sentimental. When you talk to yourself, others don't listen. You are sentimental. When you talk to yourself and others also listen, then mental. And that condition is called as Ashanti. The real spiritual practice is, I will not tell you, do this mantra, go to temple or do yogasana or stand on, you know, your head. No. Simple one thing you practice. Stop talking to yourself. Not to others. Others you talk. Stop talking to yourself. Ashanti will disappear. Because Ashanti is nothing but talking with yourself. Ashanti is not outside. And what is this Ashanti talking to ourselves? It happens in three ways. Number one, we keep on, like, you know, the backflash in the movies they show. Some old man sitting somewhere and he looks at the tree and then immediately he goes in the past and the whole movie is shown. In the same manner, when we have nothing to do, we simply go and sit down, and then we go on, you know, when we were there, when, so memory. And as a result, we are never available in the present. See? And this is how old people are not accepted in the young crowd. Because anything that is happening to the youngsters, the oldies bring about their past. When we were young, during our time, who is interested in our past? Everybody is concerned about their own future. But we have nothing except the past. And we have no future. And youngsters have not much of the past and all the future. This generation gap is the cause of Ashanti in the homes. Therefore, this Ashanti is going all the time in the past. You know, one of the things which I had to suffer many times is, we go to so many places. And then, Swamiji, you could not come, you know, for my son's marriage. But, you know, don't worry. No, I was never worried. No, don't worry. We have got a big, beautiful album. And then they will put that huge Mahabharata in front of me. And then I have to see that. And in that, you know, what interest I can have in that? When I have no interest in my marriage, why will I interest somebody else's marriage? But they will say, you know, it is something like Al-Qaeda, like Al-Bum. They will put in front of you. Oh God. And then, Swamiji, can you recognize her? No. But she looks like monkey. No, Swamiji, this is me. Okay. All the past. See, if you want to grow young, try this technique. Never talk about your past. Never ask anybody their past. We go throughout the world, everybody asks about our past. And I bluff. Or sometimes I avoid. Sometimes I change the topic. Sometimes I go to the bathroom. Yad gatvana nivartante. That is a peaceful place. There is no need to talk about our past. There is no need to talk or ask about anybody's past. Make this resolution in life. You will grow young every day. See, friends. Otherwise, you know, like suppose I am with our Raj. Back in Fiji, the Fiji has been fused. Forget about it. See? I was in Newcastle. You know, one boy. I really love that boy.